Nixxion, how long has it been since you've been on this server?
Oh, I have no idea. Like, when you sent me that Twitter notification saying, like, oh, hey, we found your base. I was even talking to my friend Ben that I played on this server with. And I was like, dude, how long ago were we playing on Legion of Anarchy? He had no idea. It's been a long time.
So long you don't even remember.
Yeah, like, this is like, I mean, I when we first hopped in the call, I referred to this as like the baby days of Minecraft. For me, like, these are like super early builds.
This is pretty good for a baby build, might I say.
Yeah, it was me, my friend Ben, aka Zillisys, and then we have Red Arthas, which is my friend David. He does not play WoW. Arthas is just purely, it was his own creation. He's never played any Warcraft game. But me and Ben, we mostly built like all the stuff that is on the surface here, and then Red Arthas, aka David, he built all the crap in the Nether. I never built crap in the Nether. I hate the Nether. But we had like a whole like plan with this place. Like, I think you guys said that when you first came here, but I think someone accidentally destroyed it. There was a book that you found, and it
yeah,
had,
there
like,
was lore.
We rebuilt it. It's up in the library.
Oh, is the book there?
Yeah, it was never signed initially. So if you want to sign it,
yeah. I think the library was at the top of the mountain, right?
Yeah, it was. Yes, it was up at the top. I remember.
Yeah, I'm standing next to Z-Man. I'm not sure who's the recorder, but there's like a little sign here saying Zillisys, builder of the aqueduct. I thought I built this thing, but I guess he did. When I talked to Zillisys about this base that you guys had found it, he was like, dude, I remember one thing about that damn base. It was just the fact that there's just these random little places in this base. Like, you see, it's a snow biome. But there are these random little areas where for just like a 1x1 block, it's just a normal zone and it's just rain. So you're like standing like somewhere, it's all relaxing, enjoying the snow and whatnot, the immersion. And then there's like that one spot, just raining.
Yeah, there is that one rain spot, yeah.
I wonder why it does that.
I don't know. It's an old version of Minecraft.
Nixxion and D-Man, I both got gifts.
Oh.
Here's some armor. Nixxion, this is your set. It got named.
Oh, really?
Yes.
He's got some gifts.
Let's see. I gotta remember how to play this game. inventory. There it is. Cool. I watched that one video that you guys said, or that you guys made, and you were like, yeah, you know, we can really see the World of Warcraft inspiration in this. There was no inspiration in this build.
Interesting.
Really?
Yeah, no, this was just pure imagination. Surprising. Without going into like the deep lore, me and my friends had this whole lore and background and story and characters and all this stuff. Like, whenever we played Minecraft, we would play as the Theron. These buildings and stuff, these were like the early days of like the Theron Empire, like building their little houses and stuff. And then later on, the Theron took up druidism. And so if you saw like our bases in the future, it would be like a house that had been lifted out of the ground. So it would have like dirt on top of it and trees and like rivers flowing over it and stuff. And we'd build like entire cities looking like that. And then there was this King Dothrotunet, who there's a whole story, but every server that we hopped on, we kind of progressed the lore of like the Theron and like the other like different like races that we would like kind of role play as when we would play on the server. And this was just like one of like the very proto early days.
So
and,
there are other servers with cities from you guys on it.
Oh yeah. There's lots. And there's lots of books and lore. And like, I'm very curious to see this book because I believe if I remember correctly, I think it's right here actually. There should be like a shrine. At our feet is the greatest of treasures for Bellum, Lord of Rock and Stone. He was one of like the four great deities that the Theron like revered.
I thought this was a WoW reference or something.
No, there's no WoW inspiration in this at all. This is totally like just us.
Is the booby trap underneath intentional?
Yes, I think Zillisys Ben, he put that there just as a let me see. I don't have a pickaxe or anything, but show me the booby trap. So I'm pretty sure he put. Yeah,
I fell for it.
I didn't think it was that big. Yeah, because this was an anarchy server, so there were, you know, people on here that we'd have to fight occasionally and drive them out. And I believe, I don't know if this is the same server because there were so many, but if you go like out that way, there's like a big statue of a guy and he has his hand up with like, you know, like stop. And he has like a sign at his feet and it says like, all ye who pass here shall suffer judgment of the Theron King, whatever. You know, like you'll be killed on sight. And like, so we put like warnings and like totems and it, like, it was cool. Ah, the library, here it is.
So I actually didn't know they rewrote all of the lore for you. That's cool. Shit got blown up. It was right here.
Hey, I'll throw one of you guys the books.
I wanna read. Oh.
There's more than one book in here? Yeah, there is. Oh, this one's empty. Okay. This is something that we did like more, or I did more in like future like servers. We always kept a book of like the lore of like the cities that we built. Signing clothes. There it is, dude.
Hey. The lore. I guess
the lore, dude.
I guess we'll put this back in here.
I don't know if this is the same server, but I'm like 35% sure that at one point it was me, Zilisus, Red Arthas. We were building here and I got bored of building here. So I actually left and I built an even bigger base on an island near here.
CEAJ found a base around here. So I think based on what you were saying about how there was another one somewhere. So
mm-hmm. Was it like a giant castle on an island?
Somewhat, it wasn't that big.
Okay, maybe I'm misremembering the scale. Yeah, I think there was a giant, it was the nether portal. Yeah, I remember where it is. If you guys follow me, there should be like a big like under room that leads into the nether. It's another one of like, yeah, here it is. It's another one of those like god shrines. You had like the Bellum one up at like on top of the mountain. That's like the god of like the earth and the mountains. Yes, and then this one, take unto thyself the end and hold forevermore infinity, see pause brought to the beginning. This god's name was Araxul. So he was like the deity of like the nether and death. I believe David built all this, I think, or maybe Zilisus did. David was completely new to Minecraft at the time. He was like the total Minecraft infant. And so we kind of just threw him in the nether and just told him, just build stuff in the nether. Don't build anything on the surface world because that's where the cool stuff is.
Should we go look at the nether real quick?
I mean, we can if you want. I never went in there. Like, screw David. I hate him.
The nether base is crazy, which is the funny part, because you said your friend was like a full-blown noob. He actually cooked, though, because this shit is crazy in here.
Oh, yeah, David, when we first started playing Minecraft with him, David was pretty much like a peasant, like a little like slave serf that we just like put to work, like digging and like building the things that we didn't want to build. And so we'd put him in the nether. We'd send him out to gather resources and whatnot. Mostly Ben, not me, but sometimes me, you know, to be fair. But eventually David, with all his digging and messing around, I mean, he started building stuff like this and he became a fantastic builder. I would say in many ways he was better than me and Ben after like a little bit of time of playing the game, because he no-lifed it even more than we did for a while.
When I found this in the nether on like an anarchy server too, my mind was just going wild on what was on the other side, because I was like, if you're ballsy enough to build something like this in the nether.
Right.
It's crazy. You did move up to the standards.
Bruh. Oh man.
Run.
Oh, oh man. No, oh. No.
Oh.
No.
Oh, careful.
That's all good.
G-Man, nice. Don't hit him.
No worry, we're fine. It's fine. Like,
yeah, you're in like the perfect place for it too.
I am.
This is a repeat of last time.
Yeah, this is terrible. This happens all the time.
I'm gonna like kind of wander into the wild, because you guys have already kind of done the base tour on your previous video.
Yeah.
So I'm gonna kind of try to find this one base that I built, because I feel like Zilisus was building this road here that I'm following that leads off into nowhere. I believe this was meant to sort of be a road that connected the two bases. So do you guys just like go around and just dig up like archaeological Minecraft servers and just see what's on them?
I do, yeah.
CJ and Sap do. I'm kind of a documentor, sort of. I just think it's cool that people do it, so I just was like, let me make a video about it. So I asked him, and then that's how that first video was made.
This was definitely built by us. I'm just trying to remember, did I build this? It's kind of coming back to me, because I remember, if this is the same server, I do remember working on this castle that was way too big and way too ambitious.
Oh, here it is. There's a railway that's attached.
Okay, yeah, the railway.
Yep.
So I am remembering correctly.
Yeah, I've done a lot of the archiving on a lot of different servers, and this is one of the coolest 2012 around give or take bases I've found.
We didn't see this last time.
Yeah, so this was all me, 100%. Like, Ben and David, screw them. Like, I was like, I'm leaving. I hate you filthy Aroxul worshippers. Like,
I'm gonna go.
Yeah. Oh, dog. Oh, wow. Yeah, I had like a little throne here for like the king, and we were doing like this whole lore that like, oh, this castle is where like the king of the Theron like was and stuff. Like, but yeah, this was 100% me, this whole base. There's even like some, like if you were to find, for example, the other bases built on other Anarchy servers and just even personal servers over the years.
Do you not happen to remember any of those servers, by the way?
I'd have to ask Zillisys.
If you can, like, get a list of them, that'd be interesting to see if any are still functioning, because Anarchy servers are kind of rare.
If you come over here, you'll actually see, like, all of our bases kind of have these, like, repeating motifs. So, like, you see, like, this, like, symbol on the wall here. So this was a symbol of the goddess Sere, who was the one who created the Theron people. So you see that symbol popping up a lot, built by me, built by Zillisys. Like I said, there's a whole, like, lore and backstory. And at one point, I was even trying to write, like, an actual book, like a legit fantasy book. Yeah, like a real book.
That's awesome.
Because there's just so much lore behind it. I mean, there was a whole language. Like, I mean, we would actually, we started writing books in Theron so that people couldn't read them.
Oh,
like, it got to, I don't remember, I remember some things. I remember we named, like, one place was called, like, Arnia Grothar. There was a lot of, like, rolling R's and stuff, and, like, Arnia, like, R means, like, light. Nia, when attached to a subject, means the opposite, so it means dark. And then Grothar means, like, I will go or something.
And so, like, you mean, like, an actual functional language. Damn.
Yeah. Like, we went like full on like J.R.R. Tolkien with it.
Is there any drafts of your book that exist? That'd be interesting to check out.
If there are, it's like on like some ancient computer of mine up in the attic. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Like, I was like messing around with it, like drawing maps and stuff. There's actually a map. I still have it to this day. It's on Incarnate. It was a section of the world. I can link it to you guys real fast if you want.
Yeah. That'd be awesome.
Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah. That's awesome. Wow.
So like this was like on that map, there's a town called Jewel, and you can sort of see maybe in the screenshots that I mentioned that like the Theron were kind of like druidic people, where instead of building a home, they'd have a druid to lift a house out of the ground. Like, so it's like you're living in like a so it's like dirt on top of the roofs and stuff.
I love that. That's awesome.
There was this one spot here, which you only get to see a small corner of it, but it's this entire mountain that we like hollowed out, and you can see it was like a whole fortress built into it with that picture.
Whoa,
that looks crazy.
That looks so cool.
Have you guys found any other like servers from like other like YouTube people or whatever?
I think this is a world's first right here, is finding someone's base from 10 years ago, them being a YouTuber now, and then inviting them to their actual base. Like this long after. It's pretty wild stuff.
This was pretty much it for this server, just this base and then like the main one that you guys already looked at. I wish I could show you more. Like, I feel like this is also small scale. Imagine in your minds like three mountains, right? And they're all like, you know, it's kind of together like a triangle or a triangle shape.
Yeah.
There's three mountains. And then what we did is our base was in the center of these three mountains, and then we built a dome over the three mountains and combined them into a single mountain. And I remember very fondly, there was a day when we were just doing our thing in our big dome base, and all of a sudden, like, we saw someone's nameplate above our heads. Somebody was walking on top of our mountain, and we could hear him fighting a creeper up there, like the fighting and stuff.
Yeah.
And then all of a sudden there was an explosion, and the guy fell through the roof and like landed right in front of me and Zillisys and died. And so probably for like the last second of his life, he just saw this huge base with like lava waterfalls and like all this stuff. And he was probably like, what the heck is this? Because as we played on Anarchy servers more and more, we really wanted to delight in, like, you know, hiding our bases. We did a lot more stuff underground, kind of dwarvenish sort of looking stuff. There was one base I remember that we built on top of a giant mountain, and around the base of the mountain we built like these little villages that looked like that's where we lived, but the villages were all completely rigged with traps,
just decoys.
total decoys. You walk in there, you walk into a house, the entire floor is pressure plates. And so it just looks like a design, but like there's just TNT under the pressure plates that blow up, and then you fall into a pit with full of lava. If the TNT don't kill you, the lava's gonna kill you.
It sounds to me like these anarchy servers were a pretty common thing back in the day.
Oh yeah, yeah, we were always on anarchy servers. So I don't know how common they were on the greater community, but we were always on anarchy servers.
I think they went all but extinct by 2016. When was the last time you like played Minecraft?
Dude, I have no idea. It's been a long time.
Do you know the date roughly of what this base would have been?
Well, I'm assuming if you're saying this is like a 2012 server, I would assume it'd be around then. I remember I believe I did like a whole redstone trap where like we could stand up on a wall, and I remember there was this guy and he walked into like that village with like two other friends of his, and I had a switch that I could flick from like up on a wall, and I would flick it and the whole village would explode. There was TNT like hidden in the walls, like everything. And so that was like our like, oh, flip that switch if there's like more than one dude in the village. You know, we want no survivors.
This right here, what we're on right now, this looks like something they were building and they didn't finish it. It looks flat. There's a staircase that goes up and then it just stops.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Yeah, I think this, because I remember like we built that first base. Then I got bored over there. I came over here. I started building all of this. And then eventually I got bored over here. And then we moved off and stopped playing Minecraft and we came back. But I believe this building was supposed to be like, I think it was either going to be like some sort of temple, or it might have also the wood, like little outlines around the windows, like the trunks, suggest to me that it also could have been like an inn or a tavern. Yeah. And then like these areas, like this probably would have been like the kitchen. And then the other side could have been like a storage room or like a feasting hall or something. I don't know. It's been too long. But I'm assuming that's what this was.
Gives it more character, because it's like someone was building this and it's not done, but it's like it's cool still, because it's like someone that was something, that was an idea at one point.
Yeah. There was also this building too that I remember working on this, and I do remember having no idea what to turn this into. So I just left it completely blank. And I was like, well, one day I'll figure out something to put in there.
Oh, we got these. Yeah. They had like lucky boxes or whatever on the server. They gave you one while you were reading and they gave me one, and they want us to open them because it's cool and they're rare.
Okay.
So we got this. I've got one. Here, you open it first, though. It's in your inventory. It's called a locked chest. And then you got a stick that's a key.
Oh yeah, I was wondering what this was.
Yeah.
So it's like, is this like an active server right now? I thought like
no.
One of you guys.
It's hella dead, but we're trying to revive it. That's kind of the idea.
Oh.
Where'd you get this, Siege? Is this some rare thing that you found and you're using it right now?
These were also supplied by Justin526. He gave all the armor, these things, and he's a player since 2012.
I got a halo, but it don't look like a halo.
It looks like you look like what's that meme from that what's that thing, Bird Box, something like that, where they got a blindfold? That's what you look like.
Oh yeah, that's cool. Yeah,
what cool one. Yeah,
is that that's the half pressure plate? Yeah, I've got the.
Hey,
what you get? Oh wow, look at you!
I got a lantern hat.
Yeah, turn yourself on, dude.
I got you.
Light me up real quick.
Oh my gosh.
I got a loose fuse. This is a funny hat though. Nice. It looks funny.
So you're telling me that this Legion of Anarchy server for all this time has been active, all these years.
It's been on this entire time.
I'd load up any day.
Yeah, yeah. It's still totally active. It's just like the player base isn't really there. Like I'd say the last 2 years has probably had nothing going on. I mean, might not have even had really anything since 2016, possibly.
And like in 10, however many years it's been, like no one has 12, actually, 12 years, like no one has destroyed this base.
Yeah, that's why this is a world's first crazy thing. This is an anarchy server.
Insane.
The base has been here for like 12 years. No one touched it. It was untouched, completely untouched. I'm like 90%
between
sure.
10 and 12 years, this is an untouched. Depending on whenever you guys joined, but yeah.
It's crazy that no one touched this base in over 10 years.
Especially with the fact that it had the biggest nether base I've ever seen on any animal character.
This whole time, I thought that one of you found this dead archive of a server, booted it up on your computer. You know, you guys did like a little local area network connection, explored it, found it. Like, oh, look at this. Cool. Oh, Nixxion. I didn't realize that the server's been active. Well, active in quotes. Like this entire time.
It's been
it's
up.
Still
yeah.
alive. That's incredible.
That's why the archive is like so important, so that you can find these bases, world download them, yeah. like screenshot them, and get them documented before they're blown up by just some rando that having a good time or doesn't know what it is. You say it's baby Minecraft, but for this like version of Minecraft, this kind of a build is just pretty remarkable.
I wonder if the harvesting machine works.
Yeah,
it works.
It does.
No, it's oh, yeah. That was another thing. Everything works still too.
If I'm not mistaken. This was made by Red Arthas. It was one of his first redstone creations.
Yeah, you did say it's like baby, but for this time period for this game, it's actually pretty crazy.
Thank you.
Like the whole.
It's crazy even for modern day, really. To be fair, like
I've never built anything like this.
Yeah, me either.
I've never built a base this big. I built some shit in like a hole every time I played. I never built a huge labyrinth.
Oh.
With lore.
Oh, there's a...
Yeah, this is a train.
Up farms, down mine. Let's go to the farms.
Oh yeah, this was another thing we were gawking at when we saw this massive...
I was very big on the railroads. I think if I'm 99% sure I built this because I'm lazy and the idea of like riding in like a train somewhere, I just thought it sounded so cool. I think we might have put David to work on like digging this though, but the idea was my idea. I don't remember this being this long, but
yeah, I know, that's why we were gawking at it. It's massive, huge,
and gold.
We made it. Oh wow, look at all this. It's a,
you're
it's
the
a,
only one there
it's
right
a
now.
Mob grinder. Yeah, I remember this.
Yeah, we saw this in the video. We love how this is a mossy cobblestone block right here where they where the loot goes. It's nah, it's all crazy. No, there was a blaze.
The flex you can able to see them like float up.
Yeah, you can watch the monsters floating up right here. I always loved like the mossy cobblestone look. It looks so cool.
Yeah, this is some good stuff. Please let us know if you your friend remembers any of the other servers. I know CEAJ will probably find everything. He found this and all that other stuff, so.
I'll ask Zillisys if he has, like, the old files for the Hands of the Divine map, like, for the RPG game that we're making.
That'd be cool as hell.
Yeah.
Do you have, like, a Patreon thing or whatever?
A Patreon?
Yeah.
Like, I mean, I got...
your channel?
No, I just use the YouTube membership system. Just makes it easier. Fair.
Same.
Yeah. So if anybody wants to support a lack of Minecraft projects in the future, you never know.
Yeah.
Just join the Nixxion channel.
I haven't seen this one. You guys are holding out on me. There was a bunch of shit we didn't see last time.
So this is the tunnel that I went through when I found the illegals, and this was like leading me up to it, and it was quite the entrance to find.
We're in here.
Very ominous. Yeah, this was the road to the illegals, basically, in my mind.
Okay,
it was quite the...
I'm teleporting 1 second.
Oh, this is, like...
Yeah, this is... What an entrance. Holy cow. This is some theatrics right here.
Let's going say. Back to 2B, I was like, oh man, I found, like, pop bobs. You know?
Yeah,
stash.
You found pop bobs.
Oh, this!
I was geeking, yeah.
Oh, yeah. Once we discovered this like lighting trick, like we used it everywhere. The
whoa,
zombies.
Whoa, there's a testificate dude in here.
Oh. Emerald for bread. How long do you think it took you to build something like this?
We worked on this for a good while. Probably, I think we played on this server for at the minimum 2 months.
Well, only?
Yeah, well,
I
actually,
thought it was
no,
a lot of progress for 2 months.
Actually, no, it probably wasn't even that to be. Well, maybe, I don't know. But I would say, because usually we'd get bored with like a base and a server after like a few weeks. So it might be less than that.
Wow.
And it's crazy that we thought this was based on something, but you guys just off the cuff made it. Was it inspired by anything?
Just like Lord of the Rings. Oh, yeah, I forgot about this, the sugarcane farm down there. How do I get down there? I think like in the original like lore, the there and were kind of like, they would like, you know, dig underground and whatnot, but they wanted to like bring nature underground. So we built a lot of like, you might have noticed this kind of room pops up a few times in this base where it's underground, but there's trees and stuff growing.
Yeah.
You had one at the island base.
Can I just say that this is like the way you, I don't know who built the portal, but the way they did it where the nether is creeping out, that's like,
yeah,
it's doubly cool because they made that a thing in the actual game, because now you can find portals in the overworld, mm-hmm. like abandoned ones,
that's
and they have nether creeping out of them. So you guys did it before Mojang even did it, so that's pretty crazy.
Mojang copied you guys.
They copied it.
I'm pretty sure it was Zillisys that did that, but yeah, I mean, I don't actually remember.
I wonder how many people did this where the nether would creep out of it. That's like it's cool.
So well, I do have to leave. Unfortunately, because I have to drive somebody somewhere.
Yeah.
Technically, I should have left 6 minutes ago, but it was cool just exploring.
Yeah, we appreciate you taking the time. Definitely. Maybe we'll invite you back. It would be funny to do another one.
Oh, sure.
Yeah. No, that'd be cool.
Anytime, anywhere, it'd be great. Yeah, we usually always like label our bases like, oh, Nixxion's house. And if you ever show up at some fantasy-inspired base and you see that word Theron, or like something, or Sere, or Bellum, or Araxul, like AXOL. Like, oh, that's Nixxion. That's Nixxion.
That's a Nixxion base.
Yeah, that's
a Nixxion base. We know that. Hey, this shout out to anyone else watching this who may have encountered a base like that and just says no, and now they know who made it.
Now they know. Well, guys, thank you very much for having me on. It was a pleasure. I would stay longer, but I do have to go.
All good.
For sure. It was very nice to meet you, bro.
Likewise.
Yeah, it was. Yeah, nice talking.
I'll hit you guys up soon once I talk to Zillisys.
Yeah.
Sounds awesome. Thank you, man. Really appreciate it.
Well, I'll see you all soon.
Sayonara.
See ya.
Dude, easy game, easy life.
Yeah, I'm going to start recording now.
Easy game. Easy life.